For centuries, Australia stood as the last sanctuary for honeybees. Among all major honey-producing nations, it alone remained free from one of nature's most formidable parasites, the varroa destructor mite. These industrious insects contribute over $4.2 billion annually to Australia's agriculture through pollination. From the blueberry fields of New South Wales to the almond groves of Victoria, their work touches every corner of the continent. Each year, in a remarkable feat of organization, beekeepers transport over 300,000 hives across the continent, the largest planned movement of insects on Earth. These vital pollinators travel thousands of miles following the bloom of different crops throughout the seasons. One third of Australia's food production depends on these tiny workers. Almonds, apples, avocados, blueberries. The list of crops requiring bee pollination reads like a grocery shopping list. Without bees, many of these foods would become rare luxuries rather than daily staples. But in the summer of 2022, this paradise was shattered. The varroa destructor, a parasitic mite no larger than a sesame seed, had finally breached Australia's borders. Despite decades of strict quarantine measures, this ancient predator had found its way in. These parasites are perfectly evolved predators. Originally targeting Asian honeybees, they made a devastating switch to European honeybees, which lack natural defenses against them. To understand the scale of this threat, imagine a human being attacked by a parasite the size of a dinner plate. Unlike most parasites, these mites don't just drink blood. They devour the bees' fat bodies, crucial tissues that serve as the insect's liver and immune system. It's a sophisticated attack that leaves the bee alive, but fatally weakened. The mite's most sinister strategy targets the next generation. They invade the brood cells where young bees develop, feeding on larvae and transmitting deadly viruses. A single mite can produce up to 20 offspring in one brood cell, creating an exponential wave of destruction. Within months of the first detection near Newcastle, authorities established a 31-mile emergency biosecurity zone. The response was swift but devastating. Over 28,000 beehives were destroyed, representing more than half a billion bees. For beekeepers, the ordeal was heartbreaking. Many watched as generations of careful breeding went up in flames. Some lost hives that had been in their families for decades, genetic lines carefully selected for their honey production and gentleness. The destruction wasn't limited to infected colonies. In designated red zones, even healthy hives had to be eliminated to create firebreaks against the mite's advance. It was a scorched earth policy that seemed to be the only way to stop the invasion. In the wild, feral honeybee colonies faced an even grimmer fate. These escapees from managed hives had thrived in Australia's wilderness for generations. Now, without human intervention, they would become breeding grounds for the mites, creating an unstoppable wave of infection across the continent. Yet, in this crisis lies an unexpected opportunity for Australia's native species. The continent hosts over 2,000 species of native bees, from the tiny stingless sugarbag bee to the striking blue-banded bee. Each species represents millions of years of evolution, perfectly adapted to Australia's unique flora. For two centuries, these indigenous pollinators have been gradually pushed aside by the introduced European honeybees. The newcomers, with their large colonies and generalist feeding habits, dominated the landscape, outcompeting their native cousins for nectar and nesting sites. But native bees possess unique abilities their European counterparts lack. Some can perform buzz pollination, vibrating at precise frequencies to release pollen from certain flowers. Others have co-evolved with specific native plants, forming irreplaceable ecological partnerships. As the varroa mite threatens feral honeybee populations, these native species might reclaim their ancient role. It's a rare example of how an environmental crisis might help restore natural balance, a silver lining in an otherwise dark cloud. In Queensland's bustling cargo port, a remarkable innovation stands out. Bright purple beehives equipped with artificial intelligence. These electronic sentinels represent humanity's latest weapon in the war against the mite. Every bee entering or leaving these hives passes through a sophisticated scanning system. Cameras capture 50 frames per second, analyzing each insect for signs of mite infection. When a threat is detected, beekeepers receive instant alerts on their phones, allowing rapid response to potential outbreaks. Meanwhile, in laboratories across the country, researchers are breeding more resistant bees. They search for individuals with special behaviors, bees that meticulously groom their hive mates, removing mites, or those that can detect and remove infected larvae before the parasites can spread. These hygienic behaviors are like an immune system for the entire colony. Some bees can detect infected larvae through sealed wax caps, removing the threat before it can spread. Others work as colony defenders, actively hunting and destroying mites they find on their nest mates. In nature's great theater of mimicry, few performers are as convincing as flower flies. These remarkable insects have evolved to look nearly identical to bees, down to the striped pattern and buzzing flight. But unlike their stinging models, these imposters harbor a secret weapon. They can work through winter. While honeybees remain clustered in their hives during cold months, flower flies continue their work. Their unusual cold tolerance, combined with their protein-rich diet of pollen, makes them surprisingly efficient pollinators. In some crops, they've been found to be as effective as bees themselves. They're not alone. Native bees, butterflies, moths, and even some beetles are joining this unlikely workforce. Together, they represent nature's insurance policy, a diverse team of pollinators that might help secure Australia's food future. On Tasmania's rugged landscape, a remarkable experiment is unfolding. Scientists have attached miniature tracking devices, tiny backpacks weighing less than a grain of rice, to thousands of bees. Each device broadcasts the insect's location, creating a detailed map of foraging patterns and colony behavior. This unprecedented study could reveal why some colonies resist the mite's assault while others succumb. The data might also show how bees adapt their behavior when faced with the parasite, providing crucial insights for conservation efforts. The battle for Australia's bees has only begun. In the coming years, the continent's agricultural landscape will transform. Some crops may become harder to grow, while others might find new pollinators. The ecosystem will adapt as it has for millions of years. This crisis marks not just a challenge to Australia's agriculture, but a turning point in the relationship between introduced and native species. As the sun sets on the era of varroa-free Australia, a new chapter in the continent's natural history begins. The future of food security for millions hangs in the balance, as does the fate of these remarkable insects that have become so crucial to human civilization. Thank you for watching. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to like, subscribe, and share it with your friends. Let us know in the comments what you'd like to see in future videos. See you next time.